Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, welcome back again to our channel with me Nurfita Masari. So today I will talk about descriptive, narrative, and procedure text. And I will explain the definition and text analysis. So first of all, I will be sharing the definition of descriptive text. Descriptive text is a text that contains the description of an object, which is an animal, place, thing, etc.
Well, you can see on the text, this is an example of descriptive text. So, social functions of descriptive text is to describe a particular person, animal, place, or thing. Okay, now let's move on to the text analysis. When writing descriptive text, there are some generic structure. First is identifications. Identifications contains about the introductions of a person, animal, place, or object will be described. Second is description. Description contains a description of something such as place, animal, things, or person by describing its features, forms, colors, or anything related to what the writer describes. Okay, next is significant lexicographical features. In descriptive text, focus on specific participants. Specific participant has a certain object, isn't common and unique, so only one. For examples, Natural Bridge National Park, the Pacific Highway, and you can see more in the purple text. Next is using attributive and identifying process, such as examples in green text like is located, lies, and over. Next, using epithets and classifiers in nominal groups, such as examples in pink underlined text like lacious, dense, and unique. And the last, using simple present tense, because the text tells the fact of the object described.
Okay, next is narrative text. What is narrative text? Narrative text is a story with complication and problematic events, and it tries to find resolution to solve the problems. Some examples of narrative text are fable, legend, fairy tale, and folk tale.
Okay, this is an example of narrative text. So, social functions of narrative text is to amuse, entertain, and to deal with actual or vicarious experience in different ways. Narrative deal with problematic events which lead to a crisis or a turning point of some kind, which in turn finds a resolution. Next, a generic structure. You can see on the text there are three parts of narrative text. First is orientations, sets the scene where and when the story happened and introduces the participants of the story. Second is complication, tells the beginning of the problems which leads to the crisis or climax. And resolution, the problem is resolved, either happy or sad ending. Actually, in narrative text, there are four parts. The first part is reorientations. Reorientation is closing remark to the story, and it is not always in the narrative text. It is optional. Okay, next is significant lexicographical features. In narrative text, focus on specific and usually individualist participants, such as examples in green text like a little girl named Snow White, your parents, etc. And next, using material process or behavioral and verbal process, such as examples in orange text like live, talking, to do, etc. Next, using relational process and mental process, such as examples in green text and in orange underlined text. And using temporal conjunctions and temporal circumstances. So, usually in narrative text, we will find use of temporal conjunctions and temporal circumstances like once upon a time, one day, when, then, etc. And the last, using past tense.
So, usually, in narrative text, in past tense. Procedure text is text that instruct how to do a particular activity, for examples, recipes, rules for games, operation manuals, science experiments, or routes, safety rules.
Okay, now this is an example of procedure text. So, social functions of procedure text is to show how something is accomplished through a sequence of actions or steps. Generic structure. First is goal or purpose. There is usually a title. And next is materials. For example, on the text, one marble per person, a hole in ground, a line distance to start from. And next is
okay,
steps.
Next we go step to
is usually in the form of imperative sentence. In procedure text, focus on generalist human agents such as examples in yellow text like two players, you, etc. And next is using simple present tense, often imperative. So, usually in imperative sentence, if not imperative, it is in the form of a simple present tense. And next, using temporal conjunctions or numbering to indicate sequence. Temporal conjunctions or numbering to indicate sequence that we usually encounter first, then, next, etc. Such as examples in white underlined text. And the last, using material process, such as examples in blue text like must stop, must check, etc.